What's good, sports gamers? And today we got some NBA 2K21 My Team news to share, and the big changes you should expect from the mode when 2K21 drops next month. So, all right, let's get it. First off, to get it out the way, whatever collection you build on current gen NBA 2K21 will carry over to your next gen console. So every card, your progression in each mode, your VC, Mati points, everything will make that move with you, so you're good. Only thing is, it only works if you're upgrading from the same console family. So Xbox One to Series X and PS4 to PS5. With that out the way, let's get into what's coming to 2K21 Mati. First off, seasons will be making their way into 2K21. As the name states, seasons will be their way to refresh different prizes and such across all the different modes in My Team. So there's something new each season that can keep the community engaged and not have outdated cards still be rewards for things way later than they should be. They're looking at each season lasting around 6 weeks, giving you plenty of time to progress through whatever the season's awards in your favorite mode is, working on the daily, weekly, and seasonal agendas to earn XP to help raise your season's level, where every time you level up will earn you a reward. And the final level will net you the grand prize, which season 1's is a pink diamond Steph Curry. Now, brand new to My Team is My Team Limited, which sadly will only be available to play Friday, Saturday, and Sunday each week, with ever-changing rules each weekend when a new event is activated. And as the title suggests, there will be lineup restrictions every weekend to change up the meta. One weekend, you could be forced to play only 23 and under players. Another weekend can only play Ruby and lower, with the main objective being to obtain as many championship rings as you can for a tiered prize. If you gain every ring from that season, you will earn the My Team Limited grand prize. This is going to get the lower level cards you don't use after a month's run for sure. Now, My Team Limited's older brother leveled up also, as My Team Unlimited is getting an upgrade as well that will now consist of gamers being tasked to battle through 9 leagues each season that you will need to pass to reach the top tier, the Galaxy Opal tier. Each league will consist of up to 12 games, with the number of wins required to reach a new tier increases the higher you go. And if you do not get enough wins in the amount of games necessary to advance, you're still going to need to win a certain amount to stay at your current tier. Going 12-0 in the Galaxy Opal tier will get you exclusive prizes to build your My Team. New to 2K21, exchanges will let you exchange your cards for prizes. Every season will feature new exchanges for you to collect and complete to earn cards. Of course, the better exchanges you have to do, the better prizes you will get. And even the ability to swap out your crazy collection of silver and gold contracts might net you a diamond one this year, giving users another way, along with My Team Limited, to utilize your whack cards. Now, after taking a break in 2K20, badge customization is back, to allow users to give that Opal brine your own personal feel. And those who are new to 2K20, it works how everything else is. The badges will be in card form and you'll be able to apply them to players, whoever is eligible for it, which will be based on the player's archetype. So that's huge. So no rebound chasing on the Earl Boykin types out here, y'all. And badge cards will be available in bronze, silver, gold, and Hall of Fame, of course. And to get the higher level badges, you will have already needed to apply the lower level ones first. So you can't jump instantly to Hall of Fame range extender on Ben Simmons. So you know those Hall of Fame badges will be hard to get. And along with everything else, your customizable badges will transfer to next gen. Now, Evo cards, despite not having fully customizable badges, will now give you the option of selecting the badge you want when you level up, and completely changing the requirements to upgrade thereafter. You want Clamps or Intimidator? Whichever one you choose will update accordingly. So not everybody's fully evolved Nate Robinson is going to be the same like it was in 2K20. And lastly, for all the goodies 2K throws our way just for playing, heck, even signing in, 2K21 is introducing a new prizing mechanism called Ascension. There will be 3 vertical tiers of prizes. Each tier contains a number of cards that you can flip over to reveal a prize. And in each tier, one card, when flipped, levels you up to the next tier. And in the third tier, there will be a grand prize card hidden in the mix. If you can find it, you should go to Vegas ASAP. But on the real, you will get a very high level card for free. And like everything in My Team this year, a new grand prize card will be there each season. And you will have a limited amount of picks to achieve greatness from this. Some of the cards you flip will reward you with additional picks as well to help you not run out. Whether you get the grand prize or not, you're going to get something useful to help your squad out in 2K21 My Team. Sorry people, with that, what do you guys think are the biggest changes coming to NBA 2K21's My Team? What is your favorite and what are you not a big fan of? Let me know in the comments down below. And stay tuned here at Sports Gamers Online for more NBA 2K21 content. So make sure to subscribe to the channel if you haven't. And for the full NBA 2K21 My Team blog, link is in the description. Alright people, I'm Chris from Sports Gamers Online. Thank y'all for watching and be good y'all.